Welcome to Chapter 4, Food Security in India. Food is as essential for living as air is for breathing. When you think about poverty, what comes to mind? It's probably an image of a person who doesn't have enough good food to eat. The poor households are more vulnerable to food insecurity whenever there is a problem of production or distribution of food crops. There is a saying like this: the world's hunger is getting ridiculous. There is more fruit in a rich man's shampoo than in a poor man's plate. Food security refers to availability, accessibility and affordability of food to all people at all times. Food security depends on the public distribution system and government vigilance and time-to-time action when this security is threatened. Meaning of food security. Food security means availability of adequate supply of basic foodstuffs at all times. Amartya Sen added a new dimension to food security. He emphasized the access to food through entitlements. The 1995 World Food Summit declared food security at the individual, household, regional, national and global levels exist when all people at all times have physical and economic access to sufficient, safe and nutritious food to meet their dietary needs and food preferences for an active and healthy life. The declaration further recognizes that poverty eradication is essential to improve access to food. Food security has the following dimensions. Availability of food. It means food production within the country, food imports and the previous year's stock stored in government granaries. Accessibility of food. It means food is within reach of every person or a person is able to get sufficient food for his survival. Affordability of food. It implies that an individual has enough money to buy sufficient, safe and nutritious food to meet one's dietary needs. The above dimensions conclude that food security is ensured in a country only if enough food is available for all the persons. Or when all persons have the capacity to buy food of acceptable quality and when there is no barrier on access to food. What is the necessity of food security in a country? Food insecurity, often rooted in poverty, it decreases the ability of countries to develop their agricultural markets and economies. Access to quality, nutritious food is fundamental to human existence. Secure access to food can produce wide-ranging positive impacts, including economic growth and job creation. Food security is needed in a country to ensure food at all times. It is needed to ensure that no person in a country dies of hunger. Effect of natural calamity on food security. Most of the time, the poorest section of society might be food insecure. But persons above the poverty line might also be food insecure when the country faces a national disaster or calamity like earthquake, drought, flood, tsunami, widespread failure of crops causing famine, etc. The total production of food grains decreases due to a natural calamity. It creates a shortage of food in the affected areas. The price of the food products goes up due to this shortage at high prices, some people cannot afford to buy food. If such calamity happens in a very wide area or is stretched over a longer time period, it may cause a situation of starvation. Massive starvation might take a turn of famine. Thus, a natural calamity affects food security adversely. A famine is characterized by widespread deaths due to starvation and epidemics caused by forced use of impure water or decaying food and loss of body resistance due to weakening from starvation. The most devastating famine in India was the famine of Bengal in 1943. 30 lakh people died in it. The price of rice, the staple diet of the people in the region, increased sharply. No famine has occurred in India since independence. But today also, there are places like Kalahandi and Kashipur in Odisha where famine-like conditions still prevails. Starvation deaths are also reported in barren district of Rajasthan, Palamu in Jharkhand and other remote areas. Food insecure people. Food and nutrition insecurity has affected the large section in India. But the most affected people in the rural areas are landless agricultural laborers, traditional artisans, and petty self-employed workers. In urban areas, the most affected are beggars and homeless people, casual laborers, and people employed in ill-paid occupations, and construction, migrant, and other seasonal workers. These workers are largely engaged in seasonal activities and are paid very low wages. The social composition, along with the inability to buy food, also plays a role in food insecurity. The SCs, STs, and some sections of the OBCs or lower caste among them, who have either poor land base or very low land productivity, are prone to food insecurity. The people affected by natural disasters who have to migrate to other areas in search of work are also among the most food insecure people. Further, many pregnant and nursing mothers and also children under the age of 5 years are food insecure people. The second National Health and Family Survey conducted during 1998-99 estimated that approximately 11 crore women and children in India are food insecure. National Health and Family Survey was a large-scale multi-round survey conducted in a representative sample of households throughout India. 3 rounds of the survey have been conducted since the first survey in 1992-93, and this was the second. The survey provided essential data on health and family welfare needed by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and other agencies for policy and program purposes, as well as information on important emerging health and family welfare issues. What are the food insecure regions? Economically backward states with high level of poverty, tribal and remote areas, regions more prone to natural disasters, like eastern and southeastern parts of Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Odisha, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra, and parts of Madhya Pradesh, consist the largest number of food insecure people. Hunger. Hunger is another aspect indicating food insecurity. Hunger is not just an expression of poverty, it brings about poverty. The attainment of food security therefore involves eliminating current hunger and reducing the risk of future hunger. Hunger has two dimensions, that is, chronic and seasonal. To create food security, current hunger should be removed and the risk of future hunger should be reduced. Chronic hunger. It is a consequence of a diet regularly deficient in quantity and quality. This is caused due to lack of income to buy food for survival. Poor people suffer from chronic hunger because of their very low income and in turn inability to buy food even for survival. But chronic hunger has reduced in rural areas from 2.3% of households in 1983 to 0.7% in 1999. In urban areas, it has reduced from 0.8% to 0.3% during the same period. Seasonal hunger. It is related to seasonal cycles of food growing and harvesting. This is prevalent in rural areas because of the seasonal nature of agricultural activities, and in urban areas because of the casual labor. Example, there is less work for casual construction labor during the rainy season. This type of hunger or seasonal hunger exists when a person is unable to get work for the entire year. It affects landless agricultural laborers in rural areas the most. In urban areas, casual construction workers suffer from this during the time when they do not get work. The proportion of households experiencing seasonal hunger in rural areas has reduced significantly from 16.2% in 1983 to 2.6% in 1999 and 2000. In urban areas, it has reduced from 5.6% to 0.6% during the same period. India is aiming at self-sufficiency in food grains since independence. India has adopted all measures to achieve self-sufficiency in food grains. The Green Revolution during the late 1960s and early 1970s helped significantly to achieve this, although the success varied from region to region. During this period, high-yielding varieties of wheat and rice were introduced in many states. The highest rate of growth was achieved in Punjab and Uttar Pradesh, where food grain production jumped from 7.23 million tons in 1964-65 to reach an all-time high of 78.9 million tons in 2012-13. Indira Gandhi, the then Prime Minister of India, officially recorded the impressive progress of the Green Revolution in agriculture by releasing a special stamp entitled Wheat Revolution in July 1968. During this period, production of food grains in Uttarakhand, Jharkhand, Assam and Tamil Nadu has dropped. West Bengal and Uttar Pradesh, on the other hand, recorded significant increase in rice yield in 2012-2013. Food Corporation of India. Food Corporation of India was set up under the Food Corporation Act 1964 in order to support operations for safeguarding the farmers, distribution of food grains throughout the country for PDS and maintaining satisfactory level of operational and buffer stocks. Minimum support price is the price at which the government purchases crops from the farmers through the Food Corporation of India. Presently, there are 27 crops being purchased with such prices, including varieties of cereals, pulses, oil seeds, fiber crops, and others. minimum support price is a safety net given to the farmers to ensure guaranteed prices and assured markets. The MSP-based procurement system is aimed to save the crops from price fluctuations due to various unwarranted factors such as the monsoon, lack of market integration, etc. Food security in India. The Green Revolution was started in early 70s. Since then, our country has avoided famine even during adverse weather conditions. India has become self-sufficient in food grains during the last 30 years due to the variety of crops grown. Food grains availability even in adverse conditions has been ensured by the government through a food security system consisting of maintaining a buffer stock of food grains along with a public distribution system or PDS for food grains and other essential items. Buffer stock. It is the stock of food grains, especially wheat and rice, procured by the government. Government purchases wheat and rice from farmers through the Food Corporation of India. The government collects it from the states having surplus production. The farmers are paid a minimum support price or MSP for their crops. The MSP is announced at the beginning of the sowing season to give an incentive to the farmers to grow more. These purchased food grains are stored in granaries as a buffer stock. This stock is maintained to distribute food grains through the PDS or public distribution system in the areas of the country where production is less. It is provided to the poorer sections of society at subsidized prices, that is, lower than the market price, which is known as the issue price. The buffer stock also helps to resolve the problem of food storage due to a calamity or in adverse weather conditions.